There are three branches of Pakistan's armed forces: the Army, the Navy, and the Air Force. Effectively, the Pakistani military machine is the sixth largest in the world. The Army is the largest branch, with an estimated 550,000 active troops. The Army is a land-based operations force, though it has aviation and amphibious assets as well. The Army is tightly organized into large formations called corps. There are 9 corps of the Pakistan Army, with each corps led by a 3-star lieutenant general. Also having corps status is the Strategic Force Command, which controls the country's nuclear arsenal. Together, the corps form the functional backbone of army operations. The generals who lead these corps are technically the army's most powerful operational officers, apart from the chief of army staff, a 4-star general whom they all report to. Each corps has a certain specified number of divisions. If the corps are the backbone, then these divisions, or DIBs, are the arms. Every corps has a particular makeup of divisions. The makeup depends on the strategic and tactical imperatives of the location and the army's threat perception, security climate, and terrain of that location. For example, most of Pakistan's armor divisions, meaning those DIBs which are equipped with tanks, are in corps located in the plains of Punjab and the deserts of Sindh. That's because, although the army has traditionally perceived a threat from across the eastern border, it is only in the terrain of the plains and the deserts where tanks can actually function, and where there is a perceived armored threat from across the border. Meanwhile, divisions of corps that are located in terrains inhospitable to the movement of heavy vehicles, like along the line of control and in Fata and Swat, are primarily infantry-based, meaning they rely heavily on foot soldiers to do the fighting. Considering that the army depends on a hierarchical superstructure because of its size and broad operational scope, the chain of command is the focal point of all army activity. Corps are led by lieutenant generals, divisions by major generals, also called 2-stars or GOCs, short for general officer commanding. Then, each division comprises of brigades, led by brigadiers, and each brigade is responsible for what is perhaps the lowest common denominator of the army's organizational hierarchy, the unit. The unit is the basic building block of the army. While corps, divisions, and even brigades have multiple tasks to perform, ranging from planning logistics and coordinating with the Air Force or the Navy and other corps, divs, and brigades, units have a specialized role. Always having a lieutenant colonel as its commanding officer, the unit has a single function: to fight or support the fight in accordance with the arm it belongs to. Arms are the specialized, task-specific centers of the army. They are broken down into 2 categories: fighting arms and supporting arms. Units from fighting arms engage in frontline combat operations. Supporting arms units play a vital role in supplementing those combat operations. The armored corps, which is based on tanks, the infantry, which is made up of foot soldiers, and the artillery, which uses heavy, long-range guns, are the fighting arms of the Pakistan Army. Supporting arms consist of the engineers, who help lay bridges and mines, the signals, who are in charge of all communications, the ordnance, which handles the arsenal, electrical and mechanical engineering, who are responsible for repairing all vehicles, army aviation, which provides air support, air defense, which provides protection from enemy air assaults, supply and transport, which is responsible for logistically aiding frontline operations, and the Army Medical Corps, which runs field ambulances as well as hospitals during wartime and peace. Effectively, the operational structure of the army is like a pyramid. Units, whether from fighting or supporting arms, form the base. They report to brigades, which report to divisions, which report to corps. The buck starts at the level of a unit, which may be based on the front line, and stops at the corps, which may be headquartered in a major city. That's the game. But who are the players?